Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss about very important topic of Java 1.8 features. Okay, that is predefined functional interface. This is one of the very important topic from Java 1.8. okay, that we should know. Okay, so we know like what is the functional interface. We have written our own single abstract method inside interface to make it functional interface. Okay, so what is the functional interface? The interface which are containing single abstract method is called functional interface. So we have been writing the interfaces, okay, and we have been calling that interfaces single abstract method using the lambda expression. So we had seen like functional interface is tightly coupled with lambda expression. So you wrote the lambda expression, but to call the lambda expression you will have to write the functional interface. So you know, Java has given its own functional interface. Okay, so you don't require to write your own interface, functional interface basically, okay, to call the lambda expression. Okay, so that interfaces are called predefined functional interfaces that Java has already provided. Okay, so what are those? The first is predicate. Don't bother about all these things. We are going to discuss each and everything in details. Okay, I will show you in a eclipse how you can write the predicate functional interface, okay, and all. So first is the predicate, second is the function functional interface, third is the consumer, okay, and fourth one is the supplier. So these are the only four predefined functional interface. Okay, okay, so let's go one by one. So predicate means predicate function will accepts input and perform some conditional check and return value. So in a writing a program, writing an applications, wherever you required to check some conditional check in a program, then you don't require to write a separate functional interfaces classes, separate lambda expression and all. You can happily use the predicate functional interface that Java has given. Okay, so this was all about the predicate. So whenever there is a requirement to perform some conditional check and it should return value like boolean true or false, you can happily use the predicate. Okay, and another is the function. So it will accept same like a predicate, okay, it will do some perform some operation, okay, and it will return something, but return may not necessary, it will be a boolean type, okay, like true or false. Okay, so it can return any kind of value, it can return a string, it can return integer, okay, it can return character. So based upon your requirement, okay, wherever the requirement is to pass the input and perform some operation and return some data type to the caller, okay, then you can go happily with the function. Okay, and third is the consumer. Okay, so consumer name itself is says that it's going to consume only. Okay, it will accept the input, okay, and it will perform some operation and it's not going to return any value. It's for only consuming. So whenever the requirement is to write any function, it will receive the input, okay, it will perform some operations, and after performing some operations, it will put data or write the things into the object or write the data into the database. Okay, so that situations you go with the consumer functional interface. Okay, and other is the supplier. So it's not going to, you know, to accept any input. Okay, so it's only just supply the object, it will return basically. Okay, so it supply your required object and will not accept any input. So some functions like, you know, if you want to write a function, like it will we know like the function is going to perform some operations, and after performing the operation it's going to return you some object, returning some result. Okay, and then at that time you should use the supplier. So these four are, you know, the predefined functional interface. So at what time you should go and what time you should use, it depends upon the, your requirement. Okay, so I explained all these three forces in a theoretically, but don't bother about that. We are going to see in Eclipse how you can achieve these things, okay, through the programming. Okay, so we see like functional interface, all these four kind of functional interface predefined we saw, and all are receiving only one parameter. So here using the by predicate, okay, it's a two argument functional interface. So whenever requirement is, you know, to receives the take the two input, okay, and return the boolean result, okay, then you should go with by predicate. By function means obviously it will accepts the two input, okay, and will return any kind of value. It not may not necessary the boolean type, it can have any type like character, string, integer, float, any kind of thing. Okay, so by consumer is the same. Okay, so it's will going to consume any consume the data. Okay, so it will have a two argument. Okay, so this is all about these things we are going to see practically in our next session. Okay, so Java has already given some primitive function interface like integer primitive, int function, int consumer specifically. So you can perform the integer kind of operations for the primitive type. Okay, sorry, it should be predicate. I have corrected this. So you know, int predicate, int function, int consumer, but the base behavior of predicate will be same, base behavior of function will be same, base behavior of consumer will be same. Predicate will always perform some operation and it will going to return some value, a boolean type value, either true or false. Function will return, function is going to accept some value and it's going to return any kind of value. Okay, it's not necessary to return the boolean type, it can have any kind of data type. Consumer is going to consume only, it's going to accept the data and it's going to perform some operations, and based upon the operation it's going to use that operations. Maybe it's we write the data into the database, to the another object, or into the file. So this is the use of the primitive functional interface. Okay, so these are the basic things you should know before moving ahead. So if you're not much clear about what is a functional interface, what is the lambda expression, how to write the lambda expression, you wrote the lambda expression, but how you will call that lambda expression using the functional interface, then go back my video and watch that. Okay, I have very much cleared the concepts about the how to write the lambda expression, how to write the functional interface, okay, and how usually you can make a call from the functional interface to the lambda expression. Okay, so thanks guys, this was all about this this first part of this predefined functional interface video. In the next part we will see in Eclipse how you can write the predicate code. Okay, how you can write the function code, consumer, supplier, function interface code that has Java has already given, so that we cannot bother to write our own interface to use the conditional kind of operation or consumer kind of operations or perform some operation to return something using the function interface. So Java has already given, they have given, you know, lots of two argument predefined function interface or predefined function interface inbuilt function interface. You can go to the Oracle document in their site and can see. But these are the main important thing you should know, and these are the very important concepts that Java has introduced with 1.8 onwards. So thanks guys, thanks for watching this video. Please do subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon. Thank you.